All right, great news, we're on the air. Hey gang, how you guys
Hello.
doing? We've got everybody here. I'll let you guys jump in here and say hello. We're at different points in the globe, roughly. So my name is Larry here, Xbox Live's Major Nelson. Welcome to the show. This week we're doing a very special episode of Blossom, as you'll soon find out. Right, guys and girls?
Blossom?
Oh.
I've seen the TV show, but I have no idea why you're using that reference.
Well, that makes it all the much more special. Anyway, welcome to the show. Of course, you can tell by everybody who... I'll let you guys... Why don't you guys tell me where you guys are located? Anybody?
I'll go first.
Okay,
I'm
you go
in
first.
A home. I'm in Redmond.
You're not in Paris?
It's the Paris Quarter, isn't it?
It is. It's some lovely artwork behind me. And I am Lollipop. Lollipop on Xbox Live and Lollipop on Twitter. That's me.
And we're very excited because we've got some really great news to share and talk about a little bit. And then, Jeffany, where are you guys located? You guys are not here in the Northwest. You're in a completely different time zone.
From you, not from each other.
Right.
Like two blocks away from each other.
But from a network point of view, we are, because my San Antonio hotel is routing all my network traffic through New York. So.
Awesome.
But Jeff and E are down in Texas for the very first PAX South, which is kind of exciting. You guys are going to be there representing Xbox. Now, I have to apologize. A couple of weeks ago, I said I was going to be there. But as many of you know, if you pay attention, we had a huge event on campus yesterday. And there's a lot going on this week. We'll be talking about that in just a minute. So I know that some of us have more to say than others. Right.
So excited.
So that's why, unfortunately, I'm not going to be able to join it. But I know E and Jeff, you guys are going to be there. What are you guys going to be doing down there? Let's get that out of the way right at the top of the show, and we'll also remind folks towards the end as well.
So I'm traveling with Undead Labs. They are the makers of State of Decay, and we are showing publicly State of Decay Year One Survival Edition. So come on down, booth 1059. I'm helping out over there and hopefully making it over to some of E's panels.
And then, E, you've got a bunch of panels going on, right?
Yes. I'm on two panels tomorrow. I'm doing one at 11 on why it's great to be in the game industry, one at 4:30 on being a gamer parent, and then I'm moderating the Indie Tabletop Showcase Saturday night.
All right. Well, that's good for you guys. You're going to be down at PAX South, and make sure you look for those guys. Now, E, you've got some preview cards to give away down there that I believe you came over to my desk and stole. Is that right?
Technically, I didn't steal them because for a change, I asked.
Yes, you did.
But yes, I do have a bunch of preview cards. I'm going to bring a chunk of them each day of the show. So if you want one, come
they
find
look
me
like
the
this.
Ask me for one. I'll hook you up.
Yeah, so that's you want to look for these guys. And on the back, I'll do this later. We've got some cards there to get in the preview program to see awesome, cool stuff. Like for instance, let's take a look here. Like this, you can see transparency on the background there. That's actually my dashboard, and you can, if you're in the preview program, you'll get access to these cool bits, as we say in the software industry. Ready?
Sure.
All right. So let's get it right out of the way. Huge week this week. Windows 10 launch. You've got some of the notes in front of you, and I know Jeff doesn't. Laura, we're gonna get to you because you have a very special section. You're gonna hang on towards the end. So why don't we go ahead and jump in, Amy? Do you have that information, those notes in front of you?
I do. Where do we want to start? Because there's a ton of information.
Why don't you start at the top.
So probably the biggest thing, and this is actually worth being super clear about, is about the free upgrade to Windows 10. So if you're coming from Windows 7, Windows 8.1, or Windows Phone 8.1, for the first year that Windows 10 exists, you can upgrade to Windows 10 for free. And there was confusion about this when we announced it. It's not you get it free for a year and then you have to pay for it. It's if you upgrade in that first year, you get it for free, and then we support that device for its lifetime for no cost.
All right.
So all those old PCs you've got knocking around, you're going to want to upgrade them, and it's not going to cost you anything.
Why not?
Cortana is coming to Windows 10.
Yeah.
So not just on Windows Phone, you'll be able to talk to your PCs.
Kind of like that, like I do every single day.
I can't see what you're doing because I'm reading from the... All
right.
I'm on my laptop. I can't see the blog post.
How about, let's talk about the Xbox app.
Yeah.
Yeah, the Xbox app is actually really cool. So it brings a lot of what you get in smart glass together with a whole bunch more features from the Xbox together into one place. So it's got your games, your friends, your messages, your activity feed, and Phil showed this yesterday. It's completely interactive, like the activity feed on the Xbox One. So you can go into your activity feed on the Xbox app in Win 10 and play game clips, DVR clips that people have done. You can comment, you can like, all that kind of stuff. And we're building in, speaking of game DVR, we're building game DVR into Windows 10.
Right.
Just like on Xbox One, you can say, Xbox, record that, or double tap the Xbox button and hit X. On Windows 10, you hit the Windows button, and I believe it's G for game DVR, and it will not only start recording, it works just like on the Xbox One where there's a buffer, so it grabs the last 30 seconds of activity. So just like you've gotten used to on your Xbox, you're going to be able to do that on your PC. They don't have to be any kind of special games, so it doesn't have to have an Xbox logo or be from Microsoft. Just any game you're playing, that's going to work.
It doesn't have to be aware or anything. It's just going to actually work. So that's the beautiful part about it, like you said.
Yeah, mm-hmm. So all your existing games, like I saw someone ask this in the Q&A, Sid Meier's Civilization Beyond Earth, Xbox record, that's going to work with that.
Yep.
Did you put Phil up to using that game as the example?
I did not, but I was very pleasantly surprised to see that.
I will say that I was in a couple of meetings where there was a lot of discussion about what title to use, and I'll just say that there was a lot of discussion, and Phil really wanted to use Civ because he's a Civ fan.
I didn't know that about him.
Yeah.
Okay. Cool. Phil becomes cooler.
Yeah. Before we get started, if you guys have any questions, feel free to ask them right here on the Google Plus page. We actually have questions working this week because I broke it last time, but it's working properly now.
Okay, go ahead. Three other things I want to hit from the announcement. Game streaming. So this is streaming games from your Xbox One to your Windows 10 PC.
Mm-hmm.
So where this is going to be most useful, I think, for people is... the TV that the Xbox One is hooked up to, someone in your house is using it. They're watching whatever they're watching, so you can't play your game. Grab your Windows 10 PC, your laptop, your desktop, your Surface, whatever, and you can remote your Xbox One to it and play your games right there. So yeah. Even though the TV's taken, you're still gaming.
Yes.
We showed what I thought was a really cool demo of DirectX 12 that I had not seen before, basically showing how by using DirectX 12, games are able to do more on existing hardware. So that's coming.
And that's really actually, you know this much better than I do, but that's really been the theme, one of the many themes of DirectX over the years, right?
There's been both. It's been let's make it more efficient, and there's been let's take advantage of new hardware features like shaders that graphic chip developers are coming up with. But in this case, it's going to bring you goodness on hardware you've already got, plus on new hardware you will get extra goodness.
Right.
And support for it's going to be in both Unreal and Unity, so a huge chunk, probably the majority of games on the market, will get this for free. They won't have to actually go do custom DirectX 12 work because they're built on Unreal or Unity.
Right.
And the last one, we showed off cross-platform play on Fable Legends. Fable Legends on a Win 10 PC playing with Fable Legends on an Xbox One. And there's still a lot more to come in that space. I did see, if you want more details on that, there's a good article on Polygon that has some Q&A with Phil talking about what's happening kind of in that area. Cross-platform play, Windows to Xbox One, with more to come when we get closer to Windows 10.
All right. And then, so there was a lot of other little, I don't want to say little news, but there's other additional news. But the big reveal came at the end of the show. And this was, of course, Microsoft HoloLens. Now, you know what? I'm just going to step back, Laura, and let you talk about it. Because this is your time. You've been working on this. In fact, one of the questions that we're seeing in the chat room here, I'm going to actually take it and I'm going to throw it. You'll see it up on your screen in just a minute. I'll let you answer this. You've been involved with this program for quite some time. Why don't you talk about that?
Sure thing. So I'm going to wait for it to pop up here. I don't see it on my screen yet. Okay, there it goes. The question was, how long has Laura been on the HoloLens project? I assume secret stuff was Xbox stuff.
Surprise!
I know, surprise. This is one of the coolest things I've ever worked on in my entire career here at Microsoft, and I've been working on it for years now. I joined the team back when it was in incubation, before it became a real thing for the company, and helped incubate it up. And now you saw one of the products I've been working on for a little while in a video right at the end of Alex Kipman's speech, which is called Onsite.
Well, we didn't see the video. We saw you in the video.
I was really honored to be a part of that video. I mean, there's been a whole team of us on the Microsoft side as well as on the JPL side working together on this product. Of course, not everybody got to be in the video, but I was one of the lucky few that made the cut to represent the product in the video. So I'm really honored to be a part of that. So where should I start? There's so many things to say.
Well, I think the journey, you know, you talked about it, it's been a few years, and
yes.
I know that I've actually experienced it many years ago when it was still in incubation, as well as you did. Now, unfortunately, Jeff and E have not seen that. So I want to be very clear to everybody.
That's several feet away from where I sit every day.
I know.
Yeah, but I want to talk about an interesting point is that everybody, you know, you guys are learning about it. You learned about it a little bit more than 24 hours ago for the very first time.
Yes.
But even Jeff and E had no idea what it was, even though we get together on a weekly basis, right?
I know. It's something that's been very, very secretive, as you guys probably know from the company. I wasn't allowed to tell anyone that was not a part of the program, even if they worked for Microsoft. So most of Microsoft did not know about this project for its lifetime. And then that meant I couldn't tell my family either.
Yeah, let's talk about that. What were those conversations like? Because when you stopped working on Xbox stuff, were they like, "Hey, so what are you working on?"
Right. Yeah. Right when I moved over to the incubation team, I couldn't tell them at all, not even a hint of what I was doing. So I had to tell them, it was something really, really cool. It's something that's going to change the world. I can't tell you what it is, but I'm super excited about it. And every conversation since had been, goes along the lines of, "Hey, Laura, how's it going?" I'm like, "Pretty good. Can you tell us what you're working on yet?" "No, not yet." Until yesterday. Yesterday was the first day that I could tell anyone, outside of the core product team exactly what I was doing. And it was a huge moment for me. And it's actually weird talking to you about this now because, I haven't been able to tell anybody until yesterday. So just saying the word hologram outside of our small little locked doors has been just so freeing.
Right.
So I actually invited my family to watch the briefing, and I tweeted about it, a couple days before and then a couple hours before. And I sent an email to my family specifically saying, "You guys should watch this tomorrow." I sent it on Tuesday, and it was on Wednesday.
Right. Right.
"You guys should watch this tomorrow because you'll see something that I know you're going to enjoy."
Right, right.
"Pay attention to the last 30 minutes because that's probably the most relevant stuff to you." So they all said they would watch it, but, they're in a different time zone, and, of course, they're very busy during their day. So I was texting them sort of right before Alex went on stage, "Are you watching? Are you watching?" And my mom said yes, my dad said yes, my sister said yes. And Alex went on and did the whole reveal, played a video. I hear nothing on text, nothing. So I text my mom and my dad. I'm like, "Are you watching? What do you think?" And my sister immediately replies, I knew it. That's so cool, and I knew it. Like, awesome, Kristen. That's cool. Didn't hear anything back from my mom or my dad. And then sort of once the whole presentation was over, I hear back from my mom. She said, I saw you. And my dad said, whoop.
That's it?
Oh, it's funny, but they were super busy. They were at work, so they couldn't really talk to me much about it. But my dad called me that evening and talked to me a lot about it. And then my mom called me right after that as well. But unfortunately, I couldn't talk to her too much because we were at an announce party, so it was really loud.
So I've known you for like a year, maybe a little more than a year, and this is like the most relaxed and the most laughy that I've ever seen.
I know, it's a really, really good day. I mean, I've been waiting for this moment for years now, and I'm finally able to tell people what I work on, because everybody has been asking me, and of course it's not a fun response to say, sorry, can't talk about what I'm working on, but it's really cool.
Right, right.
But now I get to, which is really, really fun.
Now let's talk a little bit more about it, and then we'll move on. But you were involved with the demo that. So I'll let you talk a little about what you did, and it's not even a demo; it's real stuff. So why don't you talk a little bit about what that is?
Right. So my team has partnered with the Jet Propulsion Laboratory, which of course is a part of NASA. And that day when they came in to talk to us was probably the best day of my career until yesterday. Yesterday is the best day of my career. When we got to start working with the amazing people at JPL. And I'm really sad that like Steptoe's not here, because Steptoe would just completely die to hear about this.
Right.
Because Steptoe is even more of a space fan than I am. You know, love space. You know, all of us really, Larry too, and E love space, and
how could you not
be able to work with JPL is just really a dream come true. Was never even expecting that, to work, you know, on not only on holograms, but then to work with outer space, you know, space exploration at the same time. Just, you know, no one gets to do that, but somehow, you know, I get to do that, which is way, way, way cool.
Now, why don't you? Now, Jeff, you and E haven't experienced it yet, and we need to work on that.
No, I got a demo yesterday.
Did you get to see it on site?
I got to spend about 30 minutes with it after the announcement yesterday, so, which Larry would know if he ever paid attention to my tweets.
I saw your tweet, but I didn't. You know, I didn't see you down there. I didn't know what you'd seen. Did you get to see my product?
I don't know. I got to see a part of it that hasn't been demoed yet, so I can't say.
Okay, I see what you saw.
But it was really exciting.
Awesome.
I was very unsure what it was going to feel like using it, because it is so different from virtual reality, the way it mixes your actual surroundings with the holograms.
Right.
But it didn't take long to be like, oh my goodness, I have so many ideas for what to use this for.
We'll talk about the demo, the Mars demo, in a minute. But I know, Jeff, you haven't seen anything yet. We need to get you in there, right?
Please, yeah. I watched everything. We were watching the media come in, and people were just like going crazy about it. And there was really some great reads on it. And at some point, I was like, all right, well, I'm going to catch the bus home. And I was not on the bus for 2 minutes when I get a text saying, hey, I get you in now. And I was,
missed it by that much. But the demo, I saw the demo that we're going to talk about in just a minute, and I'll let you take care of the lore. Mm-hmm. But I actually saw what some folks of the media were calling like the Minecraft demo yesterday, which I'll explain that, and then I want you to explain what you did. So this particular version was, you put the HoloLens on, and your living room turns into a Minecraft playscape. And you basically can build things. And the one that I thought was just mind-blowing is there was a coffee table in the center of the room. And you look at it through the HoloLens, and you can, like, tap on things and move things around. And I lit some TNT, and it blew a hole in the table, and I was able to actually step up and look down in and saw lava at the bottom. It was mind-blowing.
Mm-hmm.
So
Yeah, if you guys are curious, we took a lot of press through 4 different demos, so you know, feel free to look at anything that the press has said. It's me particularly, I was one of the demoers. I get the pleasure of demoing the product, and I got to walk a few press members through yesterday. So I'll give you just a quick overview of what the on-site demo was.
Yeah, what did the media get to experience yesterday? Mm-hmm.
So the demo is one that we made in partnership with the Jet Propulsion Laboratory, and the idea is that we're going to revolutionize the way that scientists operate this mission, which is by bringing a virtual representation of Mars into scientist offices and allow them to walk around and explore and plan activities for the rover as if they were really there. So we started the demo by basically dropping them at a site on Mars, and the Mars site had been generated based on images taken from the rover. So it was like the most realistic version of Mars that you know anyone's been able to see or really even walk around in. So the press person got to walk around at one of these sites and take a look at the rocks that are actually on Mars today. You know, squat down, look as you know as if they were really there on the planet. You walk around the room, check it out.
Do you want to tell the story of the first time when I saw the demo, what you said?
So when you saw the demo, I showed it to you, and you were the most active participant I think we've ever had in part of the demo. So Larry was running around the room. You looked underneath the rover. You looked underneath the desk. You were all looking around, squatting down, getting as close as possible to the floor.
And it was awesome because it felt like I was on Mars. I was like down on all fours, staring at like Mars rocks. It was crazy. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's the closest that anyone's gonna get to walking on Mars. You know, short of jumping on a rocket and going there themselves. It's really humbling because you know, you're walking around in the room, but really you're walking around on a different planet.
I've used VR before. Mm-hmm. You know. And some other things, but you know, I've always been seated, or mm-hmm. I did like the Game of Thrones thing, and you can't move. Like, are you actually walking around in like real space as you're using
it? Yep. So we had a big office in my room. It was about 15 feet by 20 feet, and you can walk the whole borders of the office when you're wearing HoloLens. You can you feel comfortable walking around. You can still see a little bit of your surroundings, so you know where desks are. You know where the walls are. You're not running into anything or anyone. And that's the idea. We want people to walk around as if they were really on Mars, you know, using natural affordances as human beings to look at, you know, the virtual rocks from all angles, just like you would really if you were there. But the biggest part of the demo is when we took them to another site where a bunch of scientific experiments had already taken place. And what we had done is using, you know, HoloLens as a mixed reality device is to cut the desk of the office out of Mars, so you can continue using the desk and the computer on that desk. Because what we had done was we had extended the tool that scientists use at the moment to explore Mars and integrated with it, so we made that tool better. So you could click around.
Can I explain a little bit about what you told me about experiences? So it's essentially, imagine if you will, Jeff and E and everyone watching, is you're working on your computer and you've got a map open here and you kind of decide that you want to take this map or this work surface and extend it out into the room. Like you just turn your head and all of a sudden your desktop is no longer 27 inches, it's the room.
It's all around you, yeah. And it's really still like we had dropped you on a sand dune on Mars and your desk had come with you. And on your monitor is a 2D panorama of that site around you. So you have a small map on your PC and you can look around and see what is that site, you know, around you. And you can, you know, do different things on the PC. Like you can click on the panorama, which places a little flag in the world where that spot relates to. Well, yep. And you can, which is my favorite part, which is you can take the mouse and you can drag that mouse off of the 2D monitor and onto Mars. So the mouse breaks free of the 2D screen and can go all around you, and it can go wherever you look. So the idea is you can use that mouse to click on rocks to create, you know, little flags, which you could potentially save to do science activities later. But the best part, really, is walking around on Mars and using that AirTap gesture to mark up Mars as well. So that's the second beat. And then the final beat is when we took press people into our third site and introduced them to a NASA engineer who appeared as an avatar on Mars with them. So the idea is you can collaborate with other team members on Mars to create plans for the rover. So you can use that same affordances of natural gestures and natural human movements to explore the planet and to walk around and then, you know, plan activities like do a Kim Cam laser experiment right on this rock here. You know, take a picture of this rock over there, and you can have that discussion with your avatar, with your team members, and they can see exactly what you see. They can see all the markup on Mars, and they can see where you're looking, and they can see where you're standing, and they can hear you.
I kind of wanted to build a sandcastle.
Uh-huh.
Mars sandcastle.
So it's kind of like being inside a telestrator. Is that right? Like when they mark up the plays during the football game or something?
No. So we would drop little flags in the world.
No, Jeff.
it wouldn't be overlaid. Like in the telestrator, you see like a John Madden drawing little circles over the people. And it looks like it's overlaid on it. So these were we dropping little flags in the world. So they look like they were sitting directly on top of that rock, right, or over there on the hill in the distance. So we're dropping little markers around in the world to show where you might want to do further scientific experiments with the rover. But it's been, an absolute pleasure, again, to work with JPL. It's been so much fun, exploring Mars and, enabling scientists to be a lot more productive and to make better scientific judgment and scientific decisions about, what they're going to do with the rover on Mars.
So yeah, I can actually say I'm one of a handful of people that has seen what it's like to be on, or what I assume it's like to be on Mars.
Yes. Yep. So anybody who's gone through the demo has been the closest, to walking on Mars that any of humanity has ever been, which I think is a true honor to be able to say that, I walked on Mars.
Cool. And I know that you've been dying to talk about the project here, but obviously you couldn't until yesterday.
Until yesterday, yeah.
So it must feel like there's a massive burden lifted off of your shoulders now.
Mm-hmm. You can probably see it in my face. Like, I am so excited to finally be able to talk about it.
Well, I'll let Eric and Jeff talk about that.
It's a whole new Laura.
No. Yeah, we'll have to get you guys down for a demo so you can see the excitement of walking around on Mars.
I have Monday at 8:30 open. Does that work?
No, we're streaming next week, dude. We got to do the stream on Monday, remember?
I did not get to do the Mars demo or the Holo Builder demo. So I very much would like to try both of those. So.
Right,
the one that I was reading about the most, and Wired wrote about this, and I want to say Verge wrote about it, and probably a lot of other folks, but that sort of like really made it hit home was the changing of this light switch one.
Mm-hmm. Escape demo, yeah.
Can you talk about that one a bit?
Yeah, so I haven't done that demo recently. I did it a while ago when it was still sort of in development. And the idea with that one is it's a communication demo where the press person was wearing the HoloLens and they were connecting with another person who was on a tablet. And the idea was we were going to instruct the press person about how to change a light switch. And it didn't matter if that person had any experience whatsoever with electricity or changing or tools or anything like that, because the person on the tablet was going to direct them. So the tablet person could see exactly what the HoloLens wearer was seeing through some of the sensors on the device. And the tablet person could mark up the world for the person wearing HoloLens. So the tablet person could circle sort of where we needed to screw in a screw or draw a little map of how the wires should be arranged or screwed together or point with arrows which tools the person should pick up and instruct them sort of how it works by drawing in the press person's world. And yeah, it's been a great reception. Again, look at all the press write-ups of all this if you want a better description of this. But again, truly transformational way of communicating with someone else or learning about how to do a skill. I think it's very, very exciting.
Yeah, I was actually able to sit in the demo yesterday, and it was actually pretty amazing to see somebody who's not a electrician and have, you know, in this example, have an electrician who's right on the other other side, be able to say, okay, now do this, touch that, do this, touch that. And it was it was actually kind of cool. In fact, it was very, very cool. So anyway, actually, let me see if I can bring this up here. This is actually the website. If you want to go to Microsoft.com/HoloLens, you will see this little page right here. And I'm actually doing this on my console. This is the console browser. So this is they kind of showed this yesterday. This is kind of like the Windows 10 interface, and and then motorcycles and cooking, and this is I did something like this. Did you guys taken a look at this page yet?
Yeah, really cool.
The mine Holo Builder looks amazing. I can't wait to try that.
Yeah, it's a super fun experience.
Here we go. Look at this
and
right
there
here.
There it is. That's the video. So if you want to see the video that we were talking about earlier, that's it. It's just scroll down a little bit and click on the rover.
Yeah, so that's there, and then of course that's the device. So there you go. That's kind of the headline. So it's big news yesterday. So welcome back to the land of the living.
Thank you. It's been a really really busy past few weeks, as you can probably imagine. Very very busy getting ready for this.
All right. So you feel like you want to just take a break now? We'll let Ian and Jeff talk. Cause I know those guys are down there down at PAX South and they're getting hungry.
Yeah, I'm going for tacos as soon as we're done here. So
We've got a couple questions here that we're going to kind of go through. So if you have some questions, we can't answer them all, but if you have some questions about anything we just discussed or maybe some of the news from this week, why don't you go ahead and pop them in there, and if we're able to get to them, we certainly will. Jeff, want to talk a little bit about what you talked about at the top of the show, but for those people that have tuned in halfway through, why don't you tell us what you're going to be doing at PAX South, and then he will get to you.
Yeah, so I'm here with Undead Labs, creators of State of Decay and State of Decay Year One Survival Edition. We showed it as a media last week. It's coming out April 28th for Xbox One, and fans are going to be able to go hands-on. So we have a booth. It's 1059-1059. I'll be there showing media and fans there, so I do hope you come by. We do have some swag. I actually took a walk around the floor today when I picked up my badge, and I think it's just going to be, it's almost, my favorite part of any PAX is the Indie Mega Booth, and I feel like most of the floor is the Indie Mega Booth. It's almost like PAX Indie in some ways, and I feel like it's going to be a lot more, there's a lot of people I know that are coming, but I feel like it felt like kind of intimate, and I think probably the way like the oldest PAX Primes before they had to designate it as being PAX Prime.
Right.
So I think it's going to be a cool experience. I'm looking forward to it.
And then you're on some panels, right?
Yes. But actually, before I get to that, on the subject of State of Decay, on my flight down here, I was listening to the latest Podcast Unlocked, the IGN Xbox podcast.
Which I need to get on. I promise I'll get on it in 2015.
Ryan has a great 45 or 50 minute interview with the founder of Undead Labs, Jeff Strain.
Jeff.
Yeah. So it's a great interview that talks about his history in gaming and the founding of the studio, and definitely worth listening to if you're interested in that game. So I'm excited.
We've had Jeff on our show before,
Have we?
Yeah.
Okay. I've never met him, so.
When they launched State of Decay on Xbox 360, it's because I went down there. I was down there at the studios. So
okay, but yeah, that's a game I'm looking forward to seeing. I have not seen that the Xbox One version. I walked past it at I guess it was Prime last year, but didn't have time to stop and see it. So I'm going to check it out.
Well, come on by.
Yeah. So yeah, doing a couple of panels tomorrow, 11 o'clock and 4:30. If you want to find me and hit me up for some of those preview program cards, those are probably the two easiest places to find me, although I'm not going to bring them all on Friday. I'm going to bring some Friday, some Saturday, and some Sunday. So
can't make it. There's one for you.
Yep.
Is that in focus-y?
Yes, you're good.
All right, there you go. So hopefully if you want to join the preview program, that's one of the codes right there.
Yes. Do we want to burn through some Q&A here?
Yeah, why don't we go? Do you see them over there?
I do. There's a couple that I can kind of answer simultaneously.
Why don't you just go ahead and rattle, go through them. I won't even take time to pop them on the screen. Just go ahead and pop through them.
Okay. Will Cortana be on Xbox One? So we have said, and this is in Phil's blog post yesterday that Windows 10 is coming to Xbox One. We haven't given a lot of details on what exactly that's going to mean yet, so stay tuned. I don't actually know when we're going to give more details, but I would guess probably GDC or E3 mm-hmm. are the likely candidates. So stay tuned, and we'll see what's coming on that front.
All right. You got something else you see in there? And Lauren, Jeff, feel free to swing through the queues as well, and we'll see if we can get some A's.
There's one with a lot of votes about, are we going to add wireless Xbox One controller support to the PC? And this is one that we actually get a lot, and I had to go back and look. And if you go to Xbox One and or to Xbox.com and search for Xbox One wireless controller compatible PC, it'll take you right to the driver downloads. They've actually been out since June of last year.
I posted them on the blog at MajorNelson.com.
Yep. So these are the drivers you need for Windows for both x86 and x64 to make your Xbox One wireless controller work on a PC. So all that's right. Already there. Just go download the drivers, and away you go.
Thank you, Zach. You guys see any other questions you want to hit while we're together here?
Last one I definitely want to hit is there's a question about will there be an update to the Xbox to get the streaming to Windows 10 working? There is that update I referred to a couple of questions ago. Yes, there's going to be an update for the Xbox that will bring it a bunch of new features, and we haven't said anything more than that so far.
All right, lots of stuff yesterday that we showed that we're not giving any more details on what we showed yesterday, mm-hmm. but as Phil said, of course, in gaming, we will have a lot more details coming at GDC, the Game Developer Conference, which unfortunately for some of us in the industry is the exact same week as PAX East. So are you guys going to GDC, guys?
I may be at GDC for 24 hours, but I'm missing most of GDC in order to go to PAX East.
All right. What about you other two guys?
If some of my devs are there, then I'll be there. I booked a hotel, so but yeah, PAX I think is probably our primary.
Laura?
I'm making plans to come to PAX East. I don't have any plans to come to GDC at the moment.
Okay.
But that, of course, always may change.
That's right. So... Hey, I want to ask you, I want to just point out, if any of you guys, I know a lot of you have been listening to the podcast and tuning into these shows for many years, you've probably noticed that, I ask everyone what they're playing, and mm-hmm. he kind of chimes in, Jeff chimes in, and as of late, Laura hasn't had much to play, and frankly hasn't even been there because she's been working on her project, but now, and hopefully you can get back to playing games now, right?
Yes. Now the announced stuff is... hopefully mostly over. I'll have some free time.
At least your stuff. Some other people won't have free time, but you may have a little bit more.
Just a little bit more, because we've been really working hard for this announced day to make it go really well.
Jeff, so what have you been playing?
I fell back into Destiny somehow.
Did you fall back in, but you pulled me in with you.
This is true. Last night, that's right, we did that strike, and I was proud. I was proud of us, because... The weekly heroic strike is really tough. It has a modifier. It's the Fogoth strike on the moon. And it has some modifier where if you're using, plasma damage, whatever the blue buzzsaw looking thing is, it's like way more powerful, and that's great for you until the enemies start using it, and then they all start using it. And there was a point where we died, 10 times in a row, and we're like, we're not going to be able to do this. And we powered through, and we did that.
Yeah, and then the Triptarch rewarded you accordingly.
Oh, yes. There's nothing like getting a legendary engram, and it's for another class. So yeah. I may have... I had heard about that happening. I was like, it's funny. And then it happened to me, and it's not funny anymore. So I think I may have to roll a hunter when we get back. So if anyone wants to help me out with hitting a button or something.
I'm happy to help you as always, and I don't know about the other two here, guys.
The chances of me having time to play any more Destiny anytime soon are just about zero.
What are you playing? What have you been playing recently? Let's talk about that.
Last week or so at work has been really nutty. I've not played very much. I played a little more Geometry Wars 3, although I'm kind of stuck at a plateau. I've got 5 stars left to go to beat, so I can fight that last boss.
So you're almost at the last boss.
I have 95 stars. I've already gotten to level 50, but it won't unlock because I don't have 100. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. So I'm trying to scrounge 5 more stars somewhere, anywhere.
Yeah, I've tried, you know, every once in a while I'll pick that up and try and beat that last boss. I still haven't beat the last boss yet. Oh, it's going to be hard. It's a hard one. If you do beat him, let me know how you do it.
I'm going to spend more time trying to get to him than beating him, but we'll see. So that's mostly it the last week. That and finishing off the Evolve beta and the Halo 5 beta before they went dark.
I played a little bit of the Halo 5 beta, and I learned something in the Evolve beta. You and I discussed this at lunch earlier this week. I'm a terrible monster.
What?
Terrible monster.
You are a terrible monster or a...
Inept monster?
Oh, very well. Inept monster. That's a better one.
I'm completely inept. Go ahead.
I discovered, and actually, Laura, you're going to love this, the character that I was having a blast playing when I was playing as a hunter and not a monster, Kyra, who is the third medic.
Ooh.
She's one of the ones who you immediately unlocked in the beta if you pre-ordered. Mm-hmm. Her healing is, her primary weapon is a healing grenade launcher that basically has unlimited ammo and quite a bit of range. So you just kind of stand back spamming grenades at your teammates. It's a blast.
That sounds really fun. I'll definitely have to give that one a try.
Medic.
Have we figured out how we're going to run this? Like, are you going to be the monster every time?
Well, if you're at a party, you can't be the monster. So if we're playing as the four, we're the hunters.
Right. So I played quite a bit as the regular classes. Did you? So I know, Laura, you didn't play because you were busy.
Yeah. Hollow
busy. Jeff and Ian, what did you guys get a chance to play? I know, Jeff, you were traveling, so you probably didn't get a chance, right?
I missed the whole thing.
Yep. Okay. So, I mean, we'll have to figure out what our classes are. I think we know who's medic.
Yes. Thank you for letting me have my class.
Well, so we'll have to figure out what the other classes are, and we've got a lot of stuff coming out with Evolve. Did you pre-order it?
I did. It's only 3 weeks away, I think, till the game comes out.
It's almost here.
It's
almost here. Let's see. We'll continue on what we're kind of playing. We're kind of doing the show a little backwards because we had such a lot of news. I finished GTA 5 on Xbox One for the I finished on 360, of course. I finished it this time on Xbox One because a good friend of mine worked on this version of it. He's the music producer, so I wanted to finish it, and I sent him a screenshot of his name in the credits and everything. So enjoyed that as always. And I know that a lot of folks that were I was streaming over the past few weeks. So there were a lot of folks who were enjoying the stream and my foibles as I was playing the game. So there you go. That's it.
All right. Jeffrey. Congrats on finishing it.
I don't know. I popped up. Hi. What's the new music on this? Speaking of your producer friend, weren't there like 50 new tracks in that game?
Yeah, he jumped in there. He joined them quite a while ago between obviously the time it came out on... the first time it came out on Xbox 360 and PS3, and so he added a bunch of tracks in, and he sent me the list of the track list after it was all done, and it was phenomenal. So he did a lot of work on that. I'm trying. I told him, I said, look, I need to be in the next game. I need a voice, anything. I'll just be random policeman on the street. Whatever you want, I'll do it. So.
Is your friend Laszlo by chance?
Pardon me? No. No, he works with Laszlo. But I know that I've also asked them that we, if it's possible, if we can get all four of us in there. So, just FYI.
Nice. But by the way, for anyone looking for those wireless drivers, I just tweeted out the link to them. So, hop on Twitter, go look at the Vowel, and the link to those drivers is right there.
Yeah, look at it. A lot of people didn't know that. Thank you. So anyway, so let's kind of wrap up what we're doing, what we're playing here, and then I know it's late where you guys are, so we're going to let you guys go. And Carnitas, I believe, is the order of the evening. Jeff, you've already hit two or three taco trucks down there.
Yeah, swine of Texas, watch out.
I'm really sad I wasn't able to go this year to the first PAX South, which is just, I don't know, 15 minutes south of Austin, which is where I grew up. Next year, we'll have to go.
Well, I have a feeling if you go next year, or even, you know, even with PAX East and PAX Prime, there's going to be an expectation that you may have something with you. Just saying.
we'll see what happens. But man, eat some barbecue, guys. I am jealous.
They were actually. It's funny when we were, you know. So the way it works when we do the hangout on the air here is we kind of get together in the green room before I hit the button to start the broadcast. Mm-hmm. And both of them had Yelp out, and they were trying to find. Let's see, it was coffee. Tacos, and what else were you looking for?
I think that was it, wasn't it?
I don't remember, but if you have any dining,
well, go find a good barbecue place.
If you have any dining suggestions for coffee or barbecue or Tex-Mex, then hit E and Jeff up on Twitter. I'm sure they'd love to hear that.
Yeah, I'm definitely of the opinion that even if we find decidedly average Tex-Mex or barbecue, it's going to be like better than what we can ever get at home.
That's probably true.
Right, right.
Can I want to hit one more question.
Yeah, absolutely.
Chuck asks, was Illuma Room a feint or distraction? We said when Illuma Room came out, it was a tech demo. It was never announced as a product, as something you'd be able to buy. People got really excited about it because it was really cool, but it was just a, hey, let's see if we can do this and figure out what to do with it. There are a lot of smart people running around Microsoft who invent a lot of really cool things that don't immediately become products. And sometimes...
And then they do, like this.
Yeah.
Right? Right? So this is, as I said earlier, when we're getting the full walkthrough and the demonstration, this is the website you want to go to at Microsoft.com/HoloLens. Let me scroll up smoothly. There we go.
Mm-hmm.
And this is the thing. If you really want to see something really cool, I suggest scroll to the bottom and watch this video right here. Explore places you've never been.
Yay!
That right there was taken on fake Mars, right? That
is the Mars yard at JPL.
Now you
where the rover is.
Mm-hmm. Are you spent some time down there? Are you able to talk? I don't know how you silently slipped in and out, but you did it.
Yeah, I visited them a few times and. Let me say, just a dream come true to visit JPL and check out all the really cool things I have on that campus, like the Mars Yard being one of the most exciting, I'd say. So yeah, go check out that video. You'll see a few exciting places at JPL and maybe a familiar face.
Or two. All right, unfortunately, we're going to have to wrap up now, guys, because as I said, E and Jeff are starving. If you listen closely, you can hear their stomachs grumbling. And apparently... Thank you. So I'll let you guys sign off, and then Laura, I'll let you kind of wrap it up there at the end, since this is kind of your show. So I wanted to.
Thank you.
When we were planning this, the reason we wanted to make sure we couldn't do a podcast this week is everyone is scattered all over North America. But I knew that you wanted to talk about obviously what you've been working on for so long. So congratulations on a launch, by the way.
Thank you. You
and the entire team have done amazing work.
Yes, it's been an absolute pleasure to share, you know, this journey with the world.
And there's much more. There's many more stories to be told, right?
Yes, there's many, many more. This is just the surface, just scratching the surface here.
So one of the questions here in the that I'm seeing in the Q&A is: does this mean you'll be on time for future podcasts?
You know what?
Maybe.
If I was a betting man, I'd say no.
I knew you were gonna say that. So. I knew you were saying that.
All right, E, any final words before we let go?
Just that if you're at PAX South tomorrow, come find me, come find Jeff, say hi.
You get one of these. It's preview code, right? You can talk. It's okay. You can talk.
Yeah, that one's not focusing for whatever reason.
Oh, do I need to put it back? Sorry.
Yeah.
And then Jeff, why don't you talk about what booth you're going to be in while this tries to focus? Come on, focus.
Yeah, 1059. We're going to have pins, actually. They're really, really cool. If you're a Penny Arcade person, State of Decay pins, they're
did
very nice.
Did you say Penny Arcade?
I did not.
That's the official name, Penny Arcade.
Yeah, so.
And I like a pun as much as the next person.
All right, we'll rip that up there. Lordy, what would you like to say before we let everybody go? Laura?
Yes, I think you cut out my machine.
It's your turn. It's your turn to say your farewells for this week.
You cut out. Nerds? I guess we're ending early?
No, I said it's your turn to say farewells this week.
Oh, okay. Thanks for watching, guys. It's been a pleasure listening, and I hope you read some of the awesome articles that have come out and check out the video.
All right, we'll wrap it up. Thank you, guys. We'll try to come back next week. Enjoy all the great news this week with Windows 10, Xbox on Windows 10, and of course, the awesome HoloLens news. We'll talk to you next time, everybody. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.